Okay, good morning everybody. I think we've got most people here, so we'll kick things off. my name's Andy Osborne. I'm Director of Global Business Development for CA Experts. I'm just going to be your moderator today. The guy who's going to do all the hard work is Stefan Bauer, and we're going to switch to him very shortly. The format of the day is really we're going to start off with a brief introduction, which is what I'm doing now. I'm going to hand over to Stefan. He's going to go through the Universal Reporter Suite and give a fairly brief overview. We do have one or two quick poll surveys as we go through that. Then we're going to come back to me, summarize, and go through any questions that you, the audience, have asked. So use your chat window to ask questions. We'll go back at the very end and summarize those and get through as many as we can within the time period that we have. The overall session is about 45 minutes. So without much further discussion, I'm going to hand over to Stefan.
Okay, Andy, thanks. So my name is Stefan Bauer. I'm a senior consultant at CA Experts here, and I give you a brief introduction for the Universal Reporter Suite of CA Experts. So what is Universal Reporter? So I will show you one simple slide that makes things a little bit clearer. Okay, the Universal Reporter Suite is a universal reporting engine for all smart plant applications. That means the reporting engine can be fed by a lot of through a lot of different adapters. At the moment, we have the adapters for SmartPlant 3D, SmartPlant PNID, SPI, SPM, and as well PDS is working with the Universal Reporter. That means the data can come from different applications, and the way the data reporting is done are always the same regardless from what application, from what Intergraph application it comes from. Okay, let me clarify this term adapter. Adapter means this is a extraction utility, and this is adapter is a application specific extraction utility which brings the data to the Universal Reporter. For different applications, we also have edit adapters, and these edit adapters have the capability to write back data which you have changed in the Universal Reporter to your application. In case of SmartPlant 3D, SPID, and currently we are working on an edit adapter for SPI. Okay, and at the end, all the data from the Universal Reporter can be exported into MS Excel. This I will show you now. At first, let me show you something about the adapters, how to extract the data from your different applications. We have different adapters. In this case here, I will show you a 3D adapter, a PNID adapter, and an instrumentation adapter. Let me start with the PNID adapter. And you will see the way the data are extracted are quite the same overall different applications. So I started in this case two adapters. On the right side there is a PNID adapter, and on the left side there is the instrumentation adapter. So that means it looks very similar, even it is dedicated to different applications, but you see the way of extraction data are quite the same. In case of the PNID adapter, you see you can change here the plant and you can select different kind of export ways. You can extract all the data, select the drawings, associate the data, and what is the same for all adapters, for all application adapters, we have a configuration utility for this. In case of PNID, you can decide what kind of attributes you want to extract, and you see it works very simple. You bring it from the left side to the right side, you press OK, you save the changes, and at the end you extract it in an offline database. We extract it in an access file, and this access file can be opened in the Universal Reporter, and from there the reporting can be done. You just have to press the extract button, and that's all. And this is absolutely the same way of doing for the instrument report adapter I have here on the left side.
Stefan,
you can configure your attributes.
Stefan,
yes.
Can we just interrupt slightly? We've just had a response in from one of the attendees saying that, can you make the screen resolution a little bit bigger because it's difficult to see the content.
Okay.
Sorry for the interruption.
Yeah, no, thanks. Thanks for this. And okay, let me do this in this way. Okay, I think now it should be a little bit better for you to see.
Yeah, that's fine. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. And okay, so the point was the way of doing the extraction for all the different with all the different extractors are always the same. So in case of our 3D report adapter, it is also the same, and I start the 3D report adapter, and you see the way of the handling for the extraction is always the same. So you just have to select what task you want to select. You select, in case of 3D, a filter really from your 3D model database, and at the end you extract it in a database. So this is the extraction part, and this should not be a very big problem. And once when you have your databases, your extractions with all your attributes, you can start the Universal Reporter. Okay, that I will do now. I open up a database, what I have extracted, and you see here your attributes. So I have extracted in this case, or we have extracted two different tasks from 3D, piping and equipment. And here in the middle panel, you see your different attributes. So I switched it off, and now I can switch on the attributes very easily, area system, unit system, commodity class, commodity type, these different things. What you want to report, let's assume you want to make, let's say, a standard Wolf report or something like that. So in this way, you can bring your attributes you want to see in the resulting report at the end to the to this left panel list. So in this right panel list, you can use filters, and you can customize your report at the end. Press on a button, export to Excel, and you have it in Excel as a result. What you also can do is you can prepare or you can use report views. Report views are queries on the database, and let me open this standard Wolf report view, and you will see what happens. Once when you have such a view, you can save this view, so your report at the end is completely customized. You can execute your view on a database that you have created, and you export it to Excel. You can use a template. There is also a template configurator in the Universal Reporter, and at the end you create a report, and the report is exported to Excel, and you see you have in a very quick way you have a report, a resulting report in Excel. So this is one way of working with the Universal Reporter. Creating reports from your database always in the same way, regardless from what application they come from. You can save these report queries, the configuration of your report in a view file, and you can execute these view files on your databases you have created on a nightly basis, for example. So then always you have the newest report available in here. This is the point for this, because this is a standard overview over the basic workflow for Universal Reporter. This is the point I would like to hand back to Andy for some poll questions. Okay. Andy, we can see you now. Yes.
It really helps when you unmute your mic, so I apologize for that. So we're going to go to the first poll question, and this really is, how useful is an additional flexible reporter for smart plant applications? So the choices of answers are essential, I need more flexibility. It may be needed, but you need more information to understand the features and benefits, or you don't see a need for it. The current smart plant capability is just fine. So we'll just wait a few minutes for everybody to get their answers in, and then we'll share with you the results. Just give a couple more minutes. Okay, not everybody's voted, but we're getting fairly close. We'll close the poll in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There's a last minute surge here, so keep going for a couple more seconds. Okay. So what we've got is 28% saying essential, they need more flexibility. 72% saying it, they think there may be a need for it, but they need more information. And there's 2% are very happy with the existing functionality. Okay, so we'll move back to Stefan.
Okay, thank you. I guess you can see me now again. And let's come to the next point. I would like to show you something about edit adapters. Universal Reporter has the capability not also to report the data and create Excel outputs. Universal Reporter is also able to write back data to different applications. These are the so-called edit adapters. I would like to show you something here on 3D and how it basically works. So that means I'm here in my Universal Reporter. I have my different attributes in here, and let's assume you want to write back some data or you want to change some data in your pipe.
Stefan, yes? I don't think you're sharing your screen at the moment. That's better.
Okay. So I'm here again in the Universal Reporter. I switch on some attributes. Let's assume you want to write back some changes for pipeline system on your pipe run. So I have a pipeline system in here. In my list here, and I have I switch on my operating maximum pressure and my operating maximum temperature. You see here in the list when I sort it, you see here there are already some values in here, and some lines do not have any values, some lines have some values, and let's assume you want to change some values in here. All what you have to do, and I click on this list, or at this point for this line, and I can change it, let's assume to 15 bar, and okay, there are different options shown, only change the attribute in for the selected object, apply to all values which have the value 12.1, and or you can change it for the complete filter you have here in your list. I change all the values from 15 to 15 where I have 12, and you see what happens. You see here a new column is made up, and you see this is the old value, this is the new value, and this is the way how you can change the data in here, and this is the same in here. When I change it in here, I can do this modifications in here. You see what happens. You always have in front of you an old value the new value, and then when you are absolutely sure that these values should be written back in this way, you go to Tools, write back your changes to SmartPlan 3D. Okay, this is the way. Now you are really accessing your model database from here, in case of 3D, or your PNID database from here, and the values are changed in the system. So you may ask some question, what is about security of this? What about the permissions? There is a permission utility in here where you can give really the permissions to your Windows user if write-back is allowed or not, or this user can do this write-back or not. So there is a permission utility in here. And maybe another question is, what happens when, because this database we are working here in the Universal Reporter as a snapshot, what happens when in the meantime the value in the model is changed? What happens? This is overwritten by Universal Reporter or not? The answer is no, it's not overwritten, because only the values, Universal Reporter really checks the values which are in the database, and if they are not the same anymore, the change is not written back to the database, and you are notified by Universal Reporter about this. Okay, so that means this gives you really a big opportunity to change the values here in a data grid and bring them back to in this case to your database, and the changes are done in this way. Okay. So this is also a point I would like to hand over back to Andy for some other poll questions.
Thanks, Stefan. Okay, so from the next poll question that we're looking at, how important would you consider an edit adapter? And it's very important, a regular requirement, you think? Not too important, you don't think you'd need it very frequently, or not important at all, no requirement. So again, same as before, please put your votes in as quickly as we can, and then we can move back on. About 70% of the votes in now. Ten more seconds and then we'll close it. So we'll close it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so what we've got are 38% saying very important, they'd see a regular requirement, 48% saying not too important, they may need it fairly infrequently, and then 14% not important at all. Okay, so we'll hand back to Stefan.
Okay, I'm back here. And So let's come now to another topic of Universal Reporter. So what I have shown you here until now is, okay, the way of reporting data in Universal Reporter. There is also the opportunity to write back data into your applications. And another big topic for Universal Reporter is to compare data between applications. So Universal Reporter is not only able to, not just able to report on one database you have opened in here, you can do also a cross reporting between databases, between databases. So that means you can open up in here different databases. So at the moment I have here a database or from 3D data, and I also can open here a database from PNID. So it makes up a second tab, so I can switch here between the tabs. And let's assume I want to make a comparison between 2D and 3D. And so this is my PNID database, this is my 3D database, and I want to look at some specific attributes from both, with attributes which are in both databases. In case of 3D, in the equipment task, I would like to look at my equipment names, my nozzle names, and my NPDs for the nozzles. And the equivalence on for EcoP, for PNID, are the EcoP nozzle tab. And here I have an equipment item tag. I have a nozzle item tag, and I have a nozzle diameter. So these are the attributes from 2D, and these and the attributes above are the attributes from 3D. And all what I have to do here in Universal Reporter is I bring my database from 2D to 3D, and a new window, it's called a multi-window, comes up, and I look, and there, the only thing you have to do is to select the join criteria, the link between the two databases. This is made up in a link database that can be configured by a user or by an administrator in the background. What are the joining criteria between table 1 and table 2? And then you select different join criteria if you only want to have the matching rows, if you want to have the matching from A to B, or the matching things from B to A, or you want to see all rows from both tables. I will go for this selection. I want to see in my multi-window the tables from both tables, the attributes from both tables, and a new window, a multi-window, comes up. So, and this multi-window contains the attributes from application A. These are the blue ones, and the and the attributes from application B. These are the red ones. And now, you can start doing your doing the comparison. So let's assume I want to know, okay, this is equipment item tag from 2D, and at first I look at the similarities between the equipment item tag and the equipment name from 3D, and it shows me, okay, these are the equipment from 2D and 3D which are the same. But now I want to look what are the differences between the nozzle item tag from 2D with the nozzle name from 3D. And we see here now we have the differences. And the same I can do with the differences about the NPD from 2D and 3D. And this gives me a list that I have here. Okay, these are the same equipment names from 2D and 3D, but the differences in nozzle naming and the differences in the size of the nozzle. Okay, so I can, this is one kind of reporting. When I switch, for example, the first equipment tag also to differences, you really see here a list. That means these are equipments in 3D which have no correlation to do 2D. And again, you can bring this very easily to Excel. For this, I have prepared another template. The template generation, again, is very easy. In here also, Universal Reporter has a template generator too. And I save this report, bring it to Excel, and you can distribute such a list to everyone who have to work on this issue. So that means we have here the data from PNID, we have here the data from 3D, and this data from 3D have no correlation to those in 2D and vice versa. Okay, and so this list gives you a good overview, and there is no need to have, for example, these two databases from 2D and 3D really connected. You just make a report from your 2D database, you just make a report of your 3D database, and via Universal Reporter you can compare your data in here and get the results. Okay, so, and by the way, this not only works between 2D and 3D, this also works between instrumentation and PNID with all different kind of databases which can be opened or which can be accessed through the Universal Reporter. And the links for this comparison data can be defined in a link database in the background, and this is a very flexible thing and a very easy thing to configure. And at the end you get a result of, we can compare the data from different applications. Okay, so Andy, I would switch back to you for our last set of poll questions.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so the final poll question really is how important is it to create cross-application reports such as PNID to 3D or compare reports from different dates for progress management? So let me just launch that poll. So again, looking for responses in terms of, yeah, very important, not sure, would need more information, or not important, you don't see a requirement for it. So we're getting close to everybody voting. We'll just get the last ones in. I think it's sort of slowed down, so we'll give it 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And thank you for your votes. So just to share that, we've got 63% see that as being very important, 10% not too important, 22% not sure, need more information, and 4% don't see a requirement at all. Well, we appreciate your input on that. Thank you very much. Just to finalise the session, there's really a couple of things I want to do. First off, really to summarise what we've just seen, and then go into the questions themselves that people have been asking. So first off, the Universal Reporter Suite provides one reporting engine for the complete Intergraph PP&M environment. So it doesn't matter whether it's PDS, SmartPlant, P&ID, 3D, etc. It's just the one reporting engine. We're actually using Microsoft Access to deliver portable project databases, which gives you the ability to work with data in any environment you want. As you've seen, there's a tabular interface. We can filter and sort to report and edit data with ease anyway. We have multiple application windows, which gives us the ability to combine data between applications in this one graphical user interface. Again, simple drag and drop process. So again, you know, the whole premise of this is it's simple to use. You don't need programming skills to generate these reports. So you can check, validate, report, edit, and write back data, assuming that you've been given the permissions quite easily.